Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa kafa wa salamun ala ibadihi alladhina astafa. Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa man wala ma ba'd. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is a new episode of our weekly series A Dose of Deen, where I focus on du'as from the Quran and Hadith and general common fiqh questions. Inshallah, today we will be discussing verse number 191. Verse number 191 from Surah Aal Imran. Verse number 191 from Surah Aal Imran, Surah number 3, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. O our Lord, O our Rabb, مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا. You have not created all of this. You have not created this world in vain, without any purpose. You have not created any of this without any purpose. In other words, whatever has been created is for a specific purpose. Subhanak. Glory be to you, فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ, and save us from the punishment of the fire. This dua is more of an affirmation, of course, of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us in the Quran and what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent with. But it is also a reminder to us that whatever we see in the world around us has been created for a specific purpose. Not just the universe, not just what we can observe from the universe, not just the world, not just us, but everything, the plants, the trees, the animal kingdom, every creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the seen and from the unseen, everything has been created for the worship and glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created for a particular purpose. And whenever we say this dua, we are reminding ourselves of the fact that our life has a particular purpose. All of this is not just the result of some really, really, really random accident, right? Life in this small corner of the universe on this planet is not just by accident. It is all here for a purpose, and that is a reminder to ourselves. And Subhanak, we glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the punishment of the fire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. Inshallah, today we will talk very briefly about what are the etiquettes of prayer. What are the etiquettes of salah? For the last couple of episodes, we have been talking about different aspects and different parts of salah. We talked about the prerequisites of salah, those things which are necessary in order for you to even start praying. For example, having wudu. We talked about the fara'id of salah, those things which if a person misses out, then they have to repeat their salah. Then we talked about the wajibat of salah, wajibat being a particular category of fiqh in the Hanafi school. And the wajibat of prayer are those things that if a person leaves out deliberately, if a person leaves out deliberately, then they have to repeat their salah. If a person leaves any of the wajibat out by mistake, they can rectify that mistake by doing the sijda sahu, by doing the two extra sajdas at the end of the salah. And inshallah, one of the episodes will be dedicated to that. And this is according to the Hanafi school. And then we also talked about the sunan of salah, the sunnahs of salah, those things which if a person misses out, it does not nullify the salah, it does not break their salah, but at the same time, their salah is not as good and perfect as it could have been. So the adab of the prayer, the etiquettes of the prayer are very similar in the sense that they beautify the prayer even more. They beautify the prayer even more. And some of these things are very, very understandable. For example, when you are standing, you try to refrain from excessive movement, because inshallah, in the next episode, we will be talking about those things which break a person's salah. And excessive movement, which is understood in the Hanafi school as if a person is looking at you and you are doing excessive movement and they might think that this person is not in salah, then that is going to be considered excessive movement. All in all, etiquette of salah is when you are praying, you pray in a way which reminds you of the magnitude of what you are doing. You are standing in front of Allah, you are worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To the best of your ability, you should not be fidgeting, right? To the best of your ability, you should not be moving around. When a person wants to cough, for example, in salah, they cough in a way which muffles the sound, right? You are already supposed to be coughing inside of your elbow, right? You are already supposed to be coughing inside of your elbow, just basic hygiene. So when you are coughing, you should cough in a way which does not make so much sound. But obviously, coughing does not break your salah. And sometimes when a person is praying salah, they might be very tired and they might want to yawn, right? You might want to yawn. So when you do yawn, you keep your mouth closed. Or at the very least, you just raise your hand very quickly and you cover your mouth. Because sometimes it is not possible to keep your mouth closed. You don't just let out a loud yawn when you are praying salah. If a person has very loose clothing, for example, especially in winter, you might have many, many different layers on top. Sometimes you might have a long coat or things like that. Having your clothes in a way that, you know, they are not distracting you, that they are not all over the place. At the very least, you know, keeping your clothing close to your body, right? Or if necessary, you know, take off your outer layer, take off your coat, which might get in the way of you praying salah properly and effectively. When you are praying, of course, not looking around to the best of your ability, trying to keep your gaze focused on the place of sijda. This is a way of training our eyes as well, that we are training our eyes not to look around. And outside of the salah, you will find it easier, you know, bi-idhnillah, with the permission of Allah, you will find it easier to abstain from looking at the things that are impermissible. And of course, when it comes to things such as, you know, turning off your phone, usually announcements are made in the beginning of salah that please silence your cell phone so it's not to disturb yourself or anybody else, you know, during the salah. And if somebody still doesn't want to listen or they simply forgot to turn off their phone or silence their phone and your phone starts ringing, don't let it continue ringing. Don't let it to continue ring, because not only does it distract the imam, it distracts the musallis, it distracts the other people in the jama'ah as well, and it also annoys people, it breaks the concentration of people. Right. So if a person's phone starts ringing, then as quickly and as discreetly as possible, without having too much movement, you simply turn off your, you turn off your phone, or at the very least, you silence your phone. So these are just, you know, part of the etiquettes of salah. And of course, you know, there are so many things, you know, which can be mentioned when you talk about the etiquettes of salah. But if you think about it, these are kind of like the general principles, right? Don't move around too much. Don't be a distraction to yourself and others, you know, by your clothing or by looking around. You know, when you are coughing or yawning, which are natural, you know, bodily responses, a person should try to control them and should try to keep them as quiet and as muffled as possible. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and protect us. May He give us knowledge that benefits us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the ability to pray in a way which pleases Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide, bless, and protect us all. Wallahu a'lam wa billahi tawfiq. Subhanallahi bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.